John, Indiana, and you have joined me for a chair yoga class. So you will need a chair. We will be seated the entire practice. A pillow or a block and a towel is completely optional. You may not need them at all, but if you feel like you might need some modifications due to stiffness or any physical limitations, it might be nice to have on hand. So to get started, we're just gonna find our seat here and get comfy on your chair. So I like to start by relaxing completely my back up against the chair, just to start. Go ahead and take the hands down, relax the shoulders down the back, and just close the eyes. Gently seal the lips. Just start to feel your breath moving in your body. Maybe for the first time today, you're noticing how it feels to inhale, how it feels to exhale. Just this simple act of tuning into our breath, feeling our breath moving, noticing it, paying attention to it, can start to alleviate stress, tension, pain. Just really start to help you become present into this moment for your practice. Feel where your body is connecting on your seat. Feel where on your back is connected, your hips, your bottom, your legs. And then noticing your feet on the ground. Maybe lifting your toes and then placing them back down. Taking a few moments here to let go of anything else other than what's happening on your chair, in your body, in this moment. Without changing anything, just notice the quality of your breath right now. Notice its depth, maybe the lack of depth. Notice where you feel it, where it begins, where it pauses, where it begins again. Takes practice, the letting go of all outside distractions and just getting curious about what's happening in your body. One hand to your low belly. We're going to start to deepen our breath here, start to control it a little bit. So with that hand at the low belly, as you inhale, feel the belly expand and lift. As you exhale, feel the Feel the belly release and contract. Just a few times here with your own pace. So keeping those eyes closed if it feels comfortable to do so. Just focusing here on the breath moving in your belly. This helps us send that breath low so that we can start to make it deep and full. Maybe even taking both hands. Full inhales, letting the belly expand and lift. And notice how the belly moves back towards the spine on the exhales. Take just two more full belly breaths. Let's move one hand up to our heart. So one hand at belly, one hand at heart. Move into our three-part yogic breath here. So to do this, we're going to inhale into the low belly still. Let that bottom hand lift as the belly lifts. But see if you can keep that breath moving up in through the ribs, into the chest. Feel a lift here. Brief hold at the top. And then exhale from the top all the way down. Chest releases, ribs, then belly. Okay, so that inhale is belly, ribs, chest. After that pause, release, chest, ribs, belly. Three-part yogic breath does wonders for calming the mind, relaxing the body, bringing peace and stillness. And this too takes a little practice. You might have to relearn the proper way to breathe deeply. And this hand placement kind of helps so you can guide that inhale, let the belly expand. Ribs, chest, maybe you feel that lift at the top. And to guide that exhale from the top down, we release and kind of even use your hands to push chest, ribs, belly. Very gently. Inhale, belly, ribs, chest. Exhale, chest, ribs, belly. Take three more. Allow your hands to come back down into your lap. Feel the shoulders melt away from the ears and Feel the crown of the head lifting up towards the ceiling. And just notice when we consciously improve our posture, give ourselves space in our body, the breath starts to flow easier and with more depth, which is good. So just practicing that three-part breath, you can do that on its own. You can lay in bed and do that while you're laying on your back. You can sit in this chair and do that. You can do it while driving, while standing in line at a store, when the stores reopen. So you can take that three-part yogic breath with you anywhere and just see how amazing it is to kind of lighten the mood a little bit. Okay, so we're going to add some more. We're going to add some movement. After all, breath and movement together is what makes yoga work so wonderful. That's the magic. Okay, so I'm going to come up in my seat a little bit here. So taking my back away, just to focus on a nice tall spine instead of relaxing back, we're going to engage the core. I'm going to take the feet apart a little bit. Again, just feeling grounded down here, maybe lifting, lowering the toes. We're going to start with some simple seated cat-cow movement. So we're going to inhale and arch the back. So we're drawing the shoulder blades back together. Nice arch in the back. Maybe look up slightly. Big breath in, feel the chest expand. And then as you exhale, start to round in the back. Draw the chin towards the chest. Let all that breath move out. And then continue linking breath to movement. Take that inhale as you lift. Exhale as you round the back. And we'll go through a few of these. And as you move, linking breaths and movement, focus on different areas here in your spine, maybe your shoulders, your neck, and just see how it feels. See if you feel that nice opening and stretching here. Focus on where you feel it so you can adjust movement. Give yourself a little bit more if you need. Okay, we're going to add some arm movement here. So still moving into that seated cow pose, we're going to open the arms. Feel the stretching in the shoulders, hands back. And then round into that cat pose and just see if you can bring the fingertips together. Inhale, expand. Exhale, turn inward. Feel that nice stretch in the neck, maybe slightly moving the head. Couple more, inhale, expand, and exhale. Good, let those fingers come together, clasp the hands, inhale, let's come all the way up. Good, release the hands and reach up. Okay, just very natural movement here. So even bringing these arms up towards the ceiling might be difficult. You might be stuck kind of right here, but that's okay. We're going to start to just move and kind of climb up. Reach one side, then the other, and wherever you are, you are. Okay, so you're going to get increased range of motion even if you're starting here stretching. You're going to make space the more you do this. So if this is your first time trying yoga or chair yoga, just take a little mental note of where you are as you stretch. And as you keep practicing and moving, you'll see improvement for sure. Okay, so we're stretching, reaching, reaching, and relax the shoulders down the back as you stretch. So this is like a seated mountain pose. Turn those pinkies in. You might feel activation in the muscles in your arms already. Take a breath in. Do a little twist as we exhale. Just turn the body. Neutral neck and head. So I'm just kind of moving my head in the direction of my shoulders. Inhale to come back. And exhale the other way. Good. You might notice it's easier to turn further on one side than the other. I'm just doing this one more time. If you need a break with the arms, you can take a break with the arms. Good. And again. Right back to center. Take a big breath in as you reach. Take those palms out and exhale. All the way down. Good. Inhale, palms up. Make that nice circle. Exhale, palms out. Release the hands, shoulders, shake it out a little bit here. Okay, we're going to take the hands back to the lap. Go ahead and take your right hand across to your left knee. And I'm just going to take that left hand to the side of my chair. Take a big breath in, lift. And then as you exhale, take a little twist. Good. If it's accessible, you can take your hand to the back of the chair. Use your inhales to find length in your twist. And with that exhale, maybe twist a little deeper. Good, one more breath here. Take that inhale, find length. Imagine like your spine is like a spiral staircase. Exhale. All right, I'm going to keep my hand across my knee. Take a breath in, slowly come back to center. And let's lift that left arm up to the sky. Good, big reach. And then over. Breath in. And down. All right, one more time. Inhale, reach all the way up. Exhale and just bend. Inhale to reach. Exhale down. All right, let's come back to center. Release the arms. Just twist a little bit side to side. Okay, let's take that left hand across to right knee. And take that right hand behind. So holding onto the chair, the side of the chair, the back of the chair. We're going to take an inhale to get length in the spine before we twist. And then exhale and twist. Take a couple breaths here in the twist. Use that inhale to find length. As you exhale, release and enjoy that twist. Good. One more breath. Exhale, feel the twist. Slowly come around. Take a breath in. Let's release that right arm. Come all the way up. And exhale and bend. Inhale, back once more. And let's open the arms out to the sides. Let's take our palms down so the thumbs are forward. Inhale, find that length in the spine as much as possible. Keep that length as you exhale, just relax the shoulders a bit. Okay, take another breath in. Right palm up, exhale, bend. Inhale back to center, switch palms, exhale as you bend. Using our breath, inhaling, switching those palms, exhaling, reaching. Again, inhale, back to center. Look towards that open hand. Exhale as you reach. Inhale back. Exhale, reach. Good, inhale back. Exhale, take those hands to heart center. Relax the shoulders. Close the eyes, just take a breath here. All right, releasing the hands back to the lap. Give yourself some shoulder rolls here. Bringing shoulders up to the ears, down the back. Just a few times. So now we're gonna move into adding some leg work here. So we're gonna start with some simple circles with the leg. So this is where if you have a hard time just using the hand to lift the knee and kind of bicycle it a little bit, circling it, if that's difficult at all, you can use a towel to help you. So as you lift, bringing your knee up, you'll feel the thigh coming up off the chair. Stretch the leg long and bring it forward. So it's kind of just a bicycle motion here. And if the leg doesn't come off the chair, maybe just kicking forward and back, just bending that knee feels good. So always modifying any way you need so that it's your yoga. Motion from the hip throughout the whole leg down to the toes. All right, so we're going to give a little squeeze here so we can bring that knee in and then flex the foot. So bring the toes toward the face and then point the toes. All right, we're going to stretch that leg, flex the foot again, toes toward the face. And point. Awesome. One more time. Flex. And point. All right. So we're moving into a seated figure four. So we're going to bring that knee in and take the ankle all the way across. Okay. So this is a nice, really nice hip opener. This is like when we do pigeon pose in a class on the ground. So again, this might be a little bit difficult to get the ankle up over the knee. So if it is, that's why you would use a block or a pillow. And to open the hip instead, you just place your foot up just to give a little bit of a lift and open this way. Okay. So either way, here or here, just taking a few breaths in our figure four. Feeling tall and long in the spine, just gently pushing away a little bit just to open that hip. Take a breath in and out. All right, we're gonna take it a little bit further. further. Take that breath in. And as you exhale, start to come forward any amount. So this might be good here. You might even take your hands down to your leg and rest as you come forward. Stay here for about 5 full breath cycles. So great opportunity to come back to your breath here. Sending the breath to that hip, allowing it to open and release. Long in the neck. On your next inhale, start to come back up. Hands back to the leg, you are forward all the way, and relax. So we're going to try a seated eagle pose now. So if it's accessible for you, cross that leg all the way like that. And if not, stay where you are with your foot here, the spine, your foot here, or all the way across. Okay, so for our seated eagle pose, we're going to open up those arms, get that nice stretch as the shoulders come back again. Relax them down the back. Take a breath in. As you exhale, if that right leg is over, we're gonna take that right arm under. Give yourself a little hug. Good. So inhale, get really tall. Feel the crown lifting. Exhale, relax, but keep that length. Eagle arms, if you'd like to go further, take the backs of the arms together. Maybe wrap those hands all the way around. Start to guide those elbows up to shoulder height. Breathe into that space in the back as you expand the shoulders. Feel a lifting out of the seat, out of the low back. Feel your spine lengthening here. Awesome, one more inhale. Maybe lift those elbows a little higher if they're falling. Exhale, release, unwind, and open. Good. We're going to uncross the leg, take the foot back down to the ground. Open the feet up a little bit here. Okay, so before we try all that on the other side, let's open those arms and bring the fingers up like stop signs. And down. You can link breath to movement here. Inhale. And exhale. Okay, let's add some circles. So just circle the wrists. Maybe exhale the other way. Inhale, switch directions. The other way. Good. Stretch it out. Big breath in. Open those fingers. And exhale. Release and relax. Awesome. Okay, so we're going to go to the other side. So if you like that towel for your lifts and your bicycling, you can do that. Or just take your hands under your thigh. Really getting that full range of motion wherever that is for you right now. Just feel how you feel it everywhere, from the hip to your toes. And again, remember, if it's a lot to do this, just stay where you are and see what works for you. Maybe just kicking the leg forward and back a little bit is good. Okay. give that knee a squeeze in. You can use that towel or just take hands here. Give a little squeeze. Let's flex the foot, bring the toes to the face. And then point. Good. Let's straighten that leg out. Flex, bring the toes to the face. You can really feel that underneath. And then point. That nice stretch on top. All right, let's give a little squeeze again. And find your figure four, your hip opener, foot to block, ankle across the knee. Okay. Take an inhale, feel the lift. Really using our breath to bring space into our body. Exhale, send breath to that hip as it opens here. Inhale. Exhale. Start to lean forward already. That feels good. The more you lean forward, the more you'll feel that opening. So do what works for you. Take that breath in. You fold it forward here. The arms however they're comfortable, not ever putting too much pressure on the knee. So just taking the arms where it's comfortable, getting long in the neck. Just relaxing here for 5 full breaths. Inhale, guide you back up to your seat. Good. And we'll come into eagle on this side. So whatever works for you, staying there or taking that leg across. Inhale and open. Feel that expansion. This time we'll take that left arm under. Give yourself that hug. Full eagle arms as an option, taking the backs of the arms together, wrapping those hands around. Inhale, feel that lift. Exhale. Beautiful. A few more breaths here. Inhale. Shoulders back expanding. Exhale. Hips supported in the seat. Inhale. Feel the breath moving up the spine. Exhale. Good. One more breath in. Let those elbows lift. Exhale. Release. Open wide. And release. Good. Let's take that leg down. Open those feet again. Okay. All right, this time let's open the arms and then just bend at the elbows. Take the fingertips to the shoulders. Let's take some big circles here. So we're going to come forward first. So as the arms draw back, come forward, elbows touching towards each other. Inhale as you open. Exhale as you round. Inhale. And exhale. Good. A couple more times. All right, let's switch directions. So as you inhale, coming back, opening the shoulders as you draw the shoulder blades back, release it down. Good. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Release. Let the hands come down. Feel the shoulders relaxing. Just kind of dangle the arms, let the fingers come down, relax. Okay, so we're gonna move into a couple more, another sequence here for legs and arms and back, everything together really. So we're gonna do some side angle stretches. So let's start here, feet about hips width distance. And then we're gonna take that right arm to the leg. So just kind of coming forward here. Let the left arm just hang. Okay, and if this is too much to come forward like this, you can use that pillow or block so you're not leaning forward as much. Okay, so from here, let the arm dangle. And then we're gonna start to raise up and stretch that left side body. So as we inhale, start to reach up. And then exhale, let it come down. Do that twice more, using your breath, maybe stretching more each time. So that inhale, maybe coming over like a little bend a little bit. Exhale. Release it down. Once more. Inhale. And exhale. Release. Good. Arm dangling down. Circle the wrist. Inhale, come back up. And as you exhale, just take the arm to the thighs. Okay, other side. So left arm across, right arm dangling down. Inhale, bring that arm up. Exhale, release. Relax it down. Inhale, come up. Maybe you've got the space to bend a little bit more. Expand in that right side. And exhale. Take it down. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Inhale, find that reach. And exhale. Take the arm back to the thighs. Okay, let's take the hands to the knees. Inhale, come all the way up. Relax the shoulders down the back again. Okay, so we're gonna do a little bit of seated core here. It's kind of like boat pose, but in a chair. So as much as you can, while still being perfectly safe and supported, scoot up to the front of your chair a little bit. We're gonna keep a really straight back here. So we're gonna lean back, but keeping the back straight. So I'm gonna turn to the side just to show you what I mean here. Okay. All right, so seated boat pose is what this is like here. So we're going to just kind of take a breath in to start. Exhale. All right, inhale that nice straight back. Just lean it back. Exhale, come forward. You can add arms here. So inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Good. So see how it's kind of like that boat pose. So as I lean back, I'm not touching. Exhale, use that core to come forward. couple more here. Alternating leg stretches. Let's take that right leg long. You can straighten it out here and then place it down. I'm gonna take my hands to my left thigh here to start. So take a full breath to feel length in the spine, coming out of the seat here. And then as you exhale, just start to fold forward. So you can keep your hands supported on this bent knee here. Or maybe take that right leg, or right hand rather, to your leg. Forward a little bit more. Just getting that stretch. Play with moving the foot around a little bit. So maybe flexing and pointing. Let the neck get long. So I'm scrunching here instead. Let the neck get long as you look down. And then just an option, completely optional, if you feel like trying it, take your hands to your toes. And then use that strength to lift up. Good. Get tall in the spine, get that lift. You can also be holding your hand underneath, or you can just kind of maybe reach up a little bit that way. So whatever works for you. If you've got a hold of the foot, take another breath in, and then we're gonna release with control. Don't just throw your foot down. Exhale, and slowly let it come down. Awesome. Other side, let's take that left leg long. Hands to right thigh to start. Take a breath in. And then as you exhale, just fold it forward. So whatever you did on the other side, or you might want to try it different here, you can keep your hands to thigh. Reach left hand down to ankle or toes. Long neck, flex and point. Good. And then grabbing a hold of those toes if you'd like, or your calf. Take a breath in to lift. Good. Just kind of playing with this, maybe straightening the leg a little bit. And then with control, we're gonna release. Take that inhale, find length in the spine. Exhale, let go. Slowly let that leg come down. Open the feet wide here. Again, kind of up on the front of the chair more so that my back is away from the back. We're just gonna inhale, shoulders down the back. And then as you exhale, start to fold forward. Good. So you might find that you like to keep your arms here, relax the head. If you feel like trying going forward, taking the hands all the way down, taking that full ragdoll fold here. Staying in your fold for a few more breaths. See if you can feel if you're holding your head, your shoulders, if you're being tense here. See if you can let go a little bit more. And you can still let go by holding or having the arms on the thighs. You can still release the head. Shake it out if you need to. Feel any kind of remaining tension just dropping out. On your next inhale, just lifting halfway, flattening the back. And then inhaling again to come up. Good. Just bring the feet back together, maybe coming back onto the chair completely. Let your back even come up against the back of the chair. Once more, feel the feet grounding down. Notice where your body is connecting with the support of the chair. Relax the shoulders. Soften in the face. Close the eyes. Short, simple, seated practice, and just notice the changes and maybe your mood, maybe how you feel physically, emotionally. And I encourage you, if you've got time, to take a few minutes for seated meditation here. So whether it's just 1 or 2 minutes or maybe 10 or 20 minutes, whatever works for you right now, just close the eyes. Feel the connection of your body on your seat. And come back to the focus of the breath moving in your body. And stay for as long as you'd like. See you again soon. Thank you for practicing today.